Glia actually refers to glue. The way they were originally defined is the glue of the nervous system. They're the little cells that are around the neurons that support the neurons and stick them all together. If any of these cells become dysfunctional, that will impact neurons as well, and neurons will also become dysfunctional. And that happens in a lot of diseases, like multiple sclerosis, Parkinson's disease, Alzheimer's disease. So it's important to keep glia cells functioning well.
They're producing the myelin that is important for efficient electrical conduction, and also they are sources that either can contribute to injury in the brain under circumstances of trauma or neurodegeneration, or conversely produce molecules that can be protective. And that is why we want to understand the dynamic properties of these cells and to harness them for positive purposes and remove their potential harmful effects.
I think one of the things that we've been doing for a long time at the Neuro, which is probably the best in the world, is taking cells from brain surgery. Sometimes some brain material needs to be taken out that can't be put back in. So we take advantage of that, and we can culture these cells in a dish and make different glia cell types, like oligodendrocytes or microglia. And then in a true human culture system, study the role and function of these cells in health and disease.
We have the experimental in vitro culture systems here at the Neuro. We have a technology so we can test how these cells can produce myelin in a tissue culture system and can test agents that can promote this.
One of the facilities at the Neuro is called EDDU, and this is a facility that helps to make inducible pluripotent stem cells, iPSCs. And these cells are interesting because you can derive them from human material. So you could take some skin or some blood from a patient, and then we can reprogram these cells to become stem cells. And from there, we can make different cell types. We can make neurons, we can make glia cells, and that's a really elegant model because then we can study the cell types that we wouldn't otherwise be able to study. iPSCs is really the next generation of understanding human disease. And we do that with single cells in a dish. We can make little mini brains, organoids, and we can look at how drugs interact with what these organoids or with these cells and see, hopefully discover drug targets and treatments for patients.